weight to the right foot. L stacks. Use that internal energy to help yourself to pull, turn, and to make a whole stance. Sit back. Twist step. Shift your weight. L stacks. Rotate. Shift. Whole stance. Sit back. Twist step. Shift your weight. L stacks. Open the knees. Rotate. Stretch. Whole stance. Sit back, twist step, shift your weight, L stance, open the knees, rotate, full stance. Sit back, twist step, 45 degree angle out, L stance, 90 degrees, rotate, stretch. Sit back, twist step, shift your weight, L stance. Rotate, full stance. We're going to get fancy now. We're going to start to pull our ball. Sit back. Twist step. Left hand on the bottom. Hold your ball. L stance. Front the horse's mane. Sit back. Twist step. Hold your ball. L stance. Front the wall of horse's mane. Sit back. Twist step. Hold your ball. L stance. Park the wild horse's mane. Half step forward, hold your ball. Rotate your ball to the left or spin it. Lift up your hand, lift up your foot. Put it on its toe. White crane spreads its wings. Drop your front foot. Bisect your body. Look back at your back and the top. Bring it to your ear. Set out your heel on an L stance. Brush your knee. Sit back. Twist step, shift your weight, lift your back hand, bring it to your ear, turn your face, brush your knee. Sit back, twist step, look at your back hand, bring it to your ear, turn your face, brush your knee. Half step forward, sit back, rock your front foot, lay your root on your heel. Drop your front foot, open. Lift, ear, toe, heel. Pivot to the middle, pulsing of the monkey. Open, lift, ear, toe, heel. Pivot to the middle, push it forward. Open, lift, ear, toe, heel. Pivot to the middle, pulsing of the monkey. Open. Lift, ear, toe, heel, pivot, pulsing of the monkey. Pivot your right foot, hold your ball on the T-stance, grasp the birdseye. L-stance, floor it off. Lift the knee, hold down, hold back, look back. Turn, square contact, push, separate, sit back. Push up and forward. Drop your left hand, pivot your left foot, hold your ball on the T-stance. Up with your heel, grasp the bird's tail, lower it off. Hold down, hold back, look back. Turn, square contact, push, separate, sit back, push up and forward, sit back. Cup, T-stance, cup, pull the back hand, step out, single bend. Drop your left hand, pivot your left foot, cup, parameter one, bow hands, middle, gently close, middle, one, open, middle, gently close. Middle, one, open, middle, let me close. Middle, hook the back and look at it, step out, single width. Okay, just do as much as you can. Half step forward, sit back, pat your horse, high pat on the horse. Cross at the out, in, drop gently to your heel, look for your double punch. Sit back, pivot, left hand on the outside, left foot coming up, in, out, in, serpent. Toe down, drop, halfway, here to the left to step, up, golden combo. Toe down, pivot, hook, split, drop, halfway, here to the right, to set, up, golden hop on its right. Extend the knee, heel down, hold the ball, the front, heel out and out, lay it on the right. Sit back, out, hold the ball, heel and hands, lay the shuttles on your right. Look it up. Lay the shells on her back. Bring both hands back, toe down, circle your top hand, go to the bottom of the seat to find that heel. One hand up, two hands up, bend your core, extend the knee, rush arms and hands. Rock, pivot, one sweep up, heel down, elbow down, knees bent to the right, then carry and punch. If you like this one, touch, open your fingers, sit back, push up and forth. Arm closing, drop your left hand, lift your left foot. Open your right foot, open your right hand. Close your right hand, close your right foot. To a cross hands, raise the timer, push out. Separate, drop your shoulders, closing form. Wrap around, heel up, off the ground, toe down, heel up. Starting at cow hand number 24, leaving the 10, going to down 24. So this is parameter one. Right hand, palms away, lower, left hand higher, palm facing. Open, middle, cup. Lift the left hand, meet it, close. Middle at 12 o'clock. 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, open. Middle 12 o'clock. 10 o'clock, 9 o'clock, foot, knee, close. Middle at cup. 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, open, foot, knee, middle. Doing it as a drill. 9 o'clock, foot, knee, middle at cup. Looking at your tips of your top hand, open, flip me, middle the cup, flip me, close, middle the cup, one open at 3 o'clock, looking at the tips of your fingers, flip me, close, middle the cup, 12 o'clock, one open at 2 or 3 o'clock, middle the cup, flip me, close. Watch carefully. Middle or cup. You're going to look at your back hand. You're going to hook it. By hooking, I mean the thumb is surrounded by the other fingers. The left hand now comes up across your face. You're going to step out on an L. And this is called single wing. And this is what I want to work on today. So how is single wing? Similar to our Tai Chi walk. So it is similar in that our right foot is the back foot, is on a line at a 45 degrees. Our left foot is the forward foot and it's on a line. So no 2 feet can be in the same line. So we're gonna have to put that right foot away from the plane or line of the left foot. So once we have our feet lined up, good. You're going to put your left hand palms away from you, and you're going to put a bend in your knee of your left foot. Knee bent and left hand palms up at eye level, okay, at eye level. Now, what do you do with your back hand or right hand? The back hand comes straight across from your shoulder, but I don't want it there. I want it moved slightly more, And then I want you to hook it by making as if this was a droopy hand or whatever, so your fingers are facing downwards. Now this time your thumb is surrounded by the other fingers. This is called single grip. Okay? Then we're going to go half step forward, right foot, half step. Then we're going to sit back on our right foot and we're going to open up our palms as if all our weight, which it should be, on our back foot. This is our sit back. Then we're going to pat our horse. We're going to come up with our left foot and we're going to pat the mane of our horse. So our fingers are now elevated on the mane of the horse and his neck. We're going to cross at the wrist. Okay? Left palm is facing you. When we step out with our heel, both palms turn down. Then we're going to shift our weight and we're going to bring up our right foot and right hand on the outside to kick out. In. So gently on your heel. Look clear the whole punch. And can you hold your stance? All right, good. So very good. Okay. Now let's drill. This time I won't do it as this is the first rotation. This is the second rotation. In 24, column hands is on three rotations. And this is the third rotation. Something happens when we bring the right hand back. We look at it and we hook it. The left hand comes closer to our face, similar position. And it steps out as if it's mimicking the feet to do a single grip. Right? Then we did half step forward. And then we said sit back. As if the weight of all on the back foot and our palms are helping us get that weight on the back. We said that we would tap the horse. Then we would cross at the wrist. Step out, palms down, heel down. Right hand on the outside, right foot coming up to kick out. In, drop gently on your heel. Look clear, don't touch. This is what we're going to do right now, okay? Try the best you can. All right, bow hands, okay? Middle or cup. Two, flip me close. Middle or cup. One, open. 12 o'clock, middle or cup. 9 o'clock, flip knee, close. Middle or cup. One, open. Middle or cup. Two, flip knee, close. This is our third rotation. Middle or cup. Something happens. We work the hand, back hand. We step out on an L stand. Face our palm outwards, and this is called single grip. Alright? Half step forward, sit back, palms open, pat the horse, cross at your wrist, step out, palms down, heel down, up with your right foot, right hand on the outside, kick out, in, drop gently on your heel away from the back foot, look for your double punch. Sit back, pivot, left hand on the outside, left foot coming up, and out. Okay, left foot on a line, right foot 45 degrees on another block, on a line on the other block. Left hand doesn't go beyond the toes, right hand is hooked slightly higher, okay, slightly higher. Half step forward. Sit back, pat your horse, and you're on the front toe of your foot, cross at the wrist, open step out, palms down, heel down, shift your weight to the front foot, lift up with your right hand on the outside to kick out, in, drop gently on your heel. This is called double punch. sit back, pivot. This time, left hand on the outside, left foot coming up. And out, in, circle. Let's start with single width. Okay, left foot on the line, right foot on the 45, another line. Looking at your fingertip of your middle finger, your hook hand is slightly higher. Your weight is in the middle, not favoring the front, not favoring the back. And your knee is stretched out, okay, not buckling. Okay, half step forward, sit back, palms are open, you're putting all that weight on the back foot, pat your horse, your front foot is on your toe, crossing at the wrist, step up with your heel, palms down, shift your weight to your left foot, so you're going to bring up the right foot, you're going to kick out, in, you're going to drop gently on your heel, you're going to make a fist, and you're going to look for your double punch. Sit back. Pivot. This time, left foot and left hand on the outside coming up. Kick out, in, serpent. This time, your right hand is higher as a hook hand. This is getting ready for toe down in line with your heel. You're going to drop halfway. You're going to veer to your left to set. Okay, you can do that. Let's reposition. Start the swing up. Reset. Do it with me. Left hand on the outside, left foot coming up. Left hand on the outside, left foot coming up. Kick out, pull in, serpent. Okay? So right hand is a hook hand. Left hand, palms are facing your chest. You're going to split. But you can't split any other way. Can you show me how I want you to split? Okay, just hook hand and here, I understand your hands are correct. Your weight is on your right foot. Just give me a split right now. So what are we looking for in a split? We're looking at parallel feet. You can't give me a toe facing out into the street. You have to have parallel feet, even if your left foot is on its toe. Now, the hardest part, and I want you to remember what I said, you're going to have to take it home to correct it. The toe of your left foot has to be in line with the heel of your back, your right foot. So if you start where I am, you drag it out to full extent, this is where you do your serpent. But this is easy. You say, I know how to do it. Keep my right heel on a line, come out and I'm on the line and I'm perfect. But remember, this is the right way to do it. But when you're in motion, you don't have that liberty to go look down and figure out where you're standing. So you need to take that home and figure it out. So how do you figure it out? Do it with me. Left hand on the outside, left foot coming up. Kick out in line, hook, then toe down, then drop. This is halfway because my fingers are pointing to the floor. Everything starts to then rotate to the left and I set. I like a spring and I need to move that energy up to be a golden cockle. I'm standing on its left. If you think what I told you was hard, you're going to have to place your toe down. You're going to have to pivot and you have to do the serpent the other way. This time, automatically, your toe should be still in line with that heel. That's really tricky, so you're going to have to work on that one too. Then, when you do the serpent now, when you do the serpent, your left hand is the hook hand. Okay, follow the other side now. We pivot it, and now our left hand is the hook hand. Our right hand is towards our chest. We know that we need to put our right toe in line with that heel in a parallel fashion. We need to drop. When we drop, the weight is on the back or left foot. The fingers are pointing down. We're halfway. We're going to veer to the right to set. Then we're going to slide up. Full cockle, stand on this right foot. Okay?